Hello everyone and welcome in this new demo of Squash TM in English. So today I will show you some elements of Squash TM. So first of all I will let you know that Squash TM is a full web. That means that no installation are needed on the client side. You just have to connect on Squash TM thanks to a login and a password. And it's really easy to use. It's a multi-project tool, so one user can access to several projects at once. And it's an inter-project tool. That means that elements can be shared among different projects. So here is the homepage of Squash TM, displaying a default message, but you can add your customized message to your testing team, for instance. On the left, wherever you are in the app, you can see this navigation bar. It's really important to notice that there are three main workspaces in Squash TM. The first one is the requirements workspace in blue, the green one is test cases workspace, and the purple one is campaign workspace. On the top, you have three buttons. The first one is a filter that allows you to show some of the project you are able to see. So here we have a lot of projects, but you can select one of them to display them in your tool. And in the administration button to give or ungive rights to the different users of Squash. So I will let you know later that there are several profiles allowing you to read, edit or modify test cases. So it depends on your profile. So now I show you the first workspace, requirements workspace. So the general layout of this page is the same for the three main workspaces. So on the left you have a library, on the right you have a consultation page of the element you've selected. On the left, on the top of the library, you have the different buttons, which are the same for all the requirement workspaces. The first one is to create element, copy past elements here, the two buttons, edit and rename an element, export or import elements, search elements in a search page, and the trash is to delete one of the elements. Then I will show you the different organization of the tree. So in black, displayed in black, it's the name of a project. So here we have two projects. And by clicking on the arrow, you have a tree structure with different elements, folder, subfolder, etc., to access to the specific elements. Here we are in the requirements workspace, so we can access two requirements. So I select one of them and access the information tab of the page consultation of this requirement. You can see the name of the requirement, the version, the reference. Really important to notice that you have to mention this reference if you have a large test repository. The status of this requirement, if it's under review, approved, etc. The attribute, so the first one is criticality. That means that it's the importance of your requirement, if it's critical, major, minor. The category, so here you can see the logo, the picture is functional, so we have different functional requirements, but there are a lot of other categories. And label. Label is one of the custom fields you can mention in a Squash TM. Here is a tag, but it could be also rich text fields or list, for instance. Then we have a description of the requirement. So it's the main part where you explain what is the requirement. Important to mention, by clicking on each element, you can change them. Each field are click to edit field. So it's easy to modify each of them. Here, with the description, we have a rich text field. That means that you can put a text in bold or in italic or in color and change the size of the font size, etc. So also really customizable. Here is a table where test cases verifying these requirements. That means all the test cases displayed here verified this specific requirement, that means authorization in this case. So here we have only one test case that verifies this requirement. We will show after how to modify this part. Now I will show you the third tab of this consultation tab. It's attachments. That means that you can add attachments to your specific requirement. Here is it's an image that illustrates the requirement. Now I show you the test cases workspace. So it's the general layout, it's the same, but the color is changing to remind you you are in the test case workspace, so it's green. Test cases workspace is really in the heart of SquashTM because it's the link between a requirement and a campaign workspace. So by selecting the project where we are, the folder and subfolder, you will access different test cases here. So first one, I take this one. So you have information in the consultation page that are a little bit different from a requirement workspace. We have also the name of the test case, the reference, the description, the status, if it's approved, under review, work in progress, etc. And the attributes are not exactly the same. They are weight, that means importance, like importance of the test cases, the nature of these test cases, and its type. Prerequisite is also a rich text field. That means that you can mention here what are the preconditions the tester have to check before to begin its test. So very important to notice this part. After what, we have another table. It's time, it's a requirement verified by this test case. This test case, you can see, verified four requirements. Here, you can add a link between a requirement on the left. By clicking on the plus button, you have requirement on the left that you can add with a simple drag and drop on the table which show you the requirements verified by these test cases. So the five is the requirement we just added. If you want to delete it, it's just easy, minus button, confirm, and it's gone. You also have this button to make the same operation. We go back, and now we are in the script tab. That means the different step the tester has to go through to make this test case in failure or in success. Steps are divided in two ways: actions and expected results. Action that the tester has to do, and the expected result he has to find after having done its action. This part is really customizable, really easy. You have just to select one step, drag and drop, and change the order, for instance. You have a lot of possibilities, and you can edit each part of this step easily by clicking on each of them. Now I will show you the parameters. So for this specific thing, I select another one which is composed with a parameter. Parameter is here, is this generic formula here, dollar, etc. And the parameter is name is browser here. To see what is the added values of this parameter, you click on parameter, the third tab. You will find your parameter browser and the different values which are linked to this parameter. It means that when you will add this test case in the execution, it will be divided in three test cases: one with Chrome, one with Firefox, and one with Safari. Now I will show you the search part. Donc, there is a search page. You select this button and select the search page where you can find easily all the test cases you are searching for. So for instance, I have the reference of my test case. I just put it here and search. But if you want to select all the test cases very high weight with a very high weight, or for instance, test cases which are composed of many test steps or which are linked to many requirements, you can select the number of requirements of test step and it's easy to go through. You also can check if you have custom fields and find test cases easily with this search page. Now I show you the dashboard. So the dashboard is displayed at the beginning here in the project. Here is a default dashboard with some default charts. So often test cases, for instance, remind you the number of test cases who are not linked to requirement, who are linked to one requirement, etc. Here is the status of the different test cases, the weight of the different test cases of your project, and the size. Here, if I click on this part, I will access to all the approved test cases in my project, so there are four. We can select them here and change their status if it's necessary, if needed, here. Just quickly, as simply as that. Now I show you the campaign workspace, the last one of the seven main workspace of SquashTM. So here we have also two projects displayed in black, and the purple color remind you that you are in the campaign workspace. First of all, in Squash we have a library of campaign in iteration. To remind you, a campaign here is defined by all the test cycles that are run on an application before its release, and test cycles are defined as iteration. So campaign iteration, you access the iteration and you access the third tab of the consultation page, and it's like the execution plan, like all the test cases you have to execute in your iteration one. Here you have different information, like the test case, the name of the test cases, its weight, its if it include dataset or not, its status like passed, running, ready, failure, blocked or untestable, and the user who has last executed or running the test, and the last execution is its date. To add a new test case in this list, in this execution plan, you click on the button Add and select one of the test cases in the tree structure on the left. This time it's test cases, and also drag and drop to add one of them. Here we can see that the test case we just added is with three values, and one test cases means that there are three test cases to execute, one with Chrome, one with Firefox, and one with Safari. I mentioned also that Squash is an inter-project tool, so if you want to add a test case from another project, to do so, users must have at least reading rights on the specific project they want to add. Now we go back in your execution plan and we will show you how to run a test. So to do so, you select the name of the test case and select new execution. So here we are, the first one, I just delete one of them, select it and click on new execution. A new window is displaying and show you a description, attribute and prerequisite, and the different step of this test case. So I will execute this test case and the pop-up is displayed. Remind you what is this test case. Begin, and now we have the different step we have to do to run the test. So action, expected results. So we can imagine the first one here is passed. So I select passed in status and click on the right arrow to go through the second step. Here we can say that it's okay too, so we put passed directly on the third one, and here let's say we have a bug here, So we had to report an issue, a bug, in our bug tracker. So Squash doesn't have its own bug tracker, but can connect with most of the bug tracker on the market, like Jira, like Redmine, like Mantis, like Bugzilla, etc. So here we are connected with Jira, but if you are in the first use of Squash TM, you have to connect here with your login and password from your bug tracker, and we will be connected directly with your bug tracker. So here I report an issue and access to a new page where I can mention all the selected problem I've encountered. So here is description of where we are in our testing process. I made a summary of this bug. So here is test, for instance. The navigation is, for instance, Chrome, and the version. So I have to select one of them here, A, and add an issue. This new issue is displayed in the table and allow you to access directly to the issue in Jira by clicking on this link. So we just said that it's not a step that has been passed, there is a failure, so we mention it here and quit this execution. Now we can see easily that the general status of this test case is in failure, because one of the step was in failure. Here you can have a summary of what have passed for the tester, and the link is also here for the issue in Jira. I go back to my execution plan and show you only the last tab here, non-issues, that displays to you all the issues that have been reported by your test team. Last but not least, I will show you the management workspace. You need to click on this button here and access to a management workspace that allows you to create charts like this, charts and reports and dashboard. Dashboard, it means that it's a combination between charts and reports. To create a report, it's really easy. Plus button, new report, select one of them, and it's automatically generated by Squash after having selected the perimeter. Here you can add a chart also and access to the chart creation wizard. You just have to enter all the information needed, next, and after what, you have created a new chart. Quit. And to finish, to create a dashboard like this, it's really easy. You just have to create here new dashboard, enter a name, and select one or two or three or how many you want charts or reports, and include it in this dashboard. This dashboard, after what, can be easily put in a favorite, as in the home page or in the home part of a project, to show to your testing team what are the results of the beginning of the test. Just here you can just trash, it's a trash to delete one of the elements of the dashboard. Thank you for having following us on this demo, and see you next time for another one.